Hello, I'm Gator McKlusky. After the huge success of The Longest Yard in 1974, Burt Reynolds went on to star in a handful of poorly received films, including this rare picture, WW and the Dixie Dancekings, directed by John G. Avildsen. Burt hated working with John, and you could tell by the end of the product that it wasn't what everyone hoped it would be. But this was a big moment in Burt's legacy as he was introduced to the snowman, Mr. Jerry Reed. Film is really hard to find, and hopefully someday we get a new film transfer showcasing how great Burt was in this role. I was lucky enough to score a copy of the soundtrack album featuring Jerry Reed, a few songs, and Mel Tillis, and believe it or not, there's a couple from Ned Beatty on here who's also in the film. So sit back and enjoy some rare tunes from this interesting soundtrack album. It's a record. Spins in a circle, put the needle on there. It's very odd. Give it a listen.
Next Wednesday night now.
Good night, sweetheart. Good night. We hate to leave you, but we really must say.
Now, if y'all driving home tonight, don't forget to take your car.
Good night, sweetheart.
Dream on. you dream on. So darling, I can dream on it too.
Stream.
Got to flip it over now. It's a weird thing. They can only fit like half the music, so they put the other half on the other side. I don't. It's just God. It's kind of wacky. Some people call it a record hell. Some people call it a soundtrack, but that's a different thing. Let's listen to the rest of this.
Last night I slept in a hobo camp down South Cairo, Georgia, about 5 miles out of town by a railroad track. I ate their stew and I drank their brew, I smoked their stale tobacco. I sat up to their open fire and I warmed my backside. In the meantime, me and this one particular hobo, we struck up a conversation, and I'm sure he must have noticed my surprise when he told me how his old man had died and left him sole heir to $1 million, and how he'd give it all away, and he chose a hobo's life. 'Cause he said, son, there's better things in life, and it's something gold and silver just can't buy. He said, boy, I'd rather sleep here in this dry creek bed, this wrinkled up overcoat to pillow my head, to bite that living high up on the hog, trying to keep my head till my head's in a fog. Son, there's better things in life. They grow it squirrely over money. There's better, oh, there's better things in life. Come on, come on. Well, now, I left Georgia then, and I got me a job in Opelika, Alabama. I was working for a man who drove me hard, and he paid me cheap. Oh, yes, he did. Well, I watched this poor fool work so hard trying to make that almighty dollar. And you know he had to live on pills from a drugstore down the street. Well, then like last spring when income tax came due, he just sat around for days and worried. He's trying to figure out how to cheat the government. Oh, boy, did he. Well, now, he worked so hard that he ended up inside Central State Hospital. And on his income tax, he got $14 and some few cents. Well, let me tell you, friends, there's better things in life. And you know that some things gold and silver just can't buy. Cause now he's lying out flat on his back in the bed. His nerves is all shot and he's out of his head. When he sees a bill, boy, that'll make him holler. When he sees how much he spent trying to save himself a dollar. I'm telling you, boy, there's better things in life than growing squirrely over money. Oh, there's better things in life. I say, oh yes, there's better things in life.
Lost my dog in a tomcat chase. I lost my wife to my best friend, and that left me on the losing end. Always on the losing end. Looks like I can't never win. It's been this way since I don't know when. I'm always out on the losing end. Game. I bought me a car and an aeroplane. I well quit pumping everything but win, and that left me on the losing end. Always on the losing end. Looks like I can't never win. It's been this way since I don't know when. I'm always out on the losing end. In Tennessee, he left his farm and his money to me. But when the lawyer got through with his ballpoint pen, he figured me out on the losing end. Always on the losing end. Looks like I can't never win. It's been this way since I don't know when. I'm always out on the losing end. I'm always out on the losing end.
When the jury brought in the verdict of guilty in the first degree, I guess there was no way that old judge had a knowing when he said a lifetime in prison, that my mama was a carrying me. Mama was a convict, so everybody said, a gal who had to pay for her sin. They could only see her old gray prison dress, that couldn't see the heart that beat within. Yes, I was born in prison behind them cold gray walls where they locked my mama away. My cradle, it was a hard prison bunk in the cell where me and Mama had to stay. Yes, sir, I grew up there amongst convicts, society's outcasts, your criminals, your sinners of every kind. I guess you think that's a pretty poor start in life, huh? I want to tell you one thing, though. They couldn't keep love out of there. No, sir, my friends, they couldn't keep love out of there, not with all the iron bars and the stone walls in this world. My nursemaids were the women who shared my mama's cell. My uncles were the guards who kept the keys. They taught me right from wrong. Boy, if I forgot, I ended up across that warden's knee. You know, my mama told me to hold my head up high. She said, boy, don't you ever be ashamed of anything. You know, I think she taught me the true meaning of the word pride when she said to me, son, I'm a criminal, and you ought to know that. But there's one other thing you ought to know. For every sinner behind bars, there's a thousand more outside. Mama was a convict, so everybody said, a gal who had to pay for her sin. They could only see her old gray prison dress. They couldn't see the heart that beat within.
This whole life ain't something that you live all by yourself.
There always comes a time you need a friend.
Sometimes the world can get so heavy and the road can get so long that you need someone to lend a helping hand.
I've learned life the hard way, took all my knocks and lumps,
but when I look back down the road at where I've been, I see that all the things I've done in this whole life have been more fun, 'cause I shared them with someone who was a friend. You've got to care about one another, be a friend and be a brother,
'cause you're always gonna need someone that you can lean on.
You've got to help each other out, that's what this life is all about, 'cause there ain't no way that you can make this journey alone.
Well, I guess that I'm just looking, I've been there and back.
Yes, I've seen life about every which way you can. But as far as I'm concerned, the greatest thing that a man can learn is when you're down, it's great to turn to a friend.
I've been there and back.
Yes, I've seen life about every which way you can. But as far as I'm concerned, the greatest thing that a man can learn is when you're down, it's great to turn to a friend. Turn to a
We'll be right back.
Not bad, right? One word of note. The director Avildsen's next film was a little picture called Rocky. I guess he didn't consider Burt for a role in that or any other picture in his long and successful career. Well, I'll catch you next time for another movie music spectacular. For now, Gator out.
Watch for new movie reviews and documentary series. Don't forget to subscribe and click on that bell so you know when new reviews arrive.